Hola! If you follow me on Instagram, you'll know that I've been asked to take part in a 10K with Nike this summer towards the end of June, and you'll also know, or you should know, that I'm not very pleased about it because I don't run. I'm not a fitness freak, never have been. The most fitness I've done was when I was a teenager. I used to play netball, that's about it. I was asked by Vicky, who does PR for Nike, to take part in a 5K run during London Fashion Week. I told her that I do not run, so I would politely decline. And she said, okay, no problem. About a week later, she came back and said, hi Cyrena, I know you said you don't run and you didn't want to do the 5K, but how about a 10K? Go ahead. I told you I don't run. You quoted that back to me. How is this working? I've accepted the challenge. I'll be doing the 10K in June. She was pleased to know that I've accepted the challenge. She thinks it's hilarious. But I'ma show her, honey. I would not be the last one over the line. How can I say that? Now I really have to properly train, because I actually do not want to be the last one over the line. Anyway, I've got 3 months, roughly, to go from 0 to 10K. Because as I said, I don't run. So running 10 steps, I'm out of breath. I've got to run 10K in less than an hour because I don't want to be lagging behind. So I've got to start training. So I've downloaded the Nike running app. And this thing, I feel like it's trying to taunt me, because today I've had 2 notifications to say your first day of training starts tomorrow, and then straight after you have a 4.83 kilometer run tomorrow. Okay, first day of training, 4.83 kilometers. It told me in the app, just make sure you do it, doesn't matter how long it takes, just make sure you get to the end. We'll see about that. So Vicky kindly gave me some kit to get to training, because you know, I don't have no exercise gear. She gave me some cute stuff. This is like a cute little hooded running top, dry fit running top from
Nike.
And then we got a little vest, a dry fit vest, which is very cute. I love that it's like black on black. I'm a huge fan of black. Huge, huge fan. And these leggings, these are called the legendary tight fit or something. They are amazing. And my legs are long. I have like a 35 inch leg, so nothing's long on me. But these fit all the way down to the ankle. Outfit one, because you know, being a little fashionista and a little fashion blogger, you know, you gotta look fly even when you exercise. And goddamn, my outfit to be like this little gray dry fit running t-shirt. Very, very cute. I like these dry fit leggings with the flash. So like, apparently, I guess this is for headlights, because you know, I don't think I'll be getting my picture taken when I'm running, but this is reflective, turns white. So that's gonna look fly when I'm running in the dark and the headlights be catching it like, whoa.
Okay.
Third outfit is this. Like a vest with a built-in sports bra. Very cute. Luminous yellow and gray. And I'ma wear that. I'ma wear that with these. Again, these are the, I have haven't taken the tag off of these yet, but these are the legendary tie fit. Dry fit, tie dye. You know, I'm not really about that much camo, but these are cute, they fit really nice, feel really nice on. And the last outfit, we're going in with a grey, one more time.
One more time.
A little nice long sleeve dry fit situation. And what I love about this stuff is the little thumb holes. We've got another sports bootsy in the pink with a little mesh back. Oh. And these dry fit leggings, going in with the color again, but I like the little camo styly, pixelated camo style. And then you got the mesh on the side piece and the mesh on the back piece to accentuate that calf muscle. Ooh, I like. Little pocket in the back here, don't know what that's for. Keys, change, I don't know, but I like. We got another outfit here. Nike Pro.
Okay.
They got a little knee detailing right here. Very cute. I would like you to know this knee detailing does not sit on my knees because my legs are long. My knees are not in the correct place for regular clothing, but they're cute nonetheless. This hoodie goes with that. Has the same kind of texture. Don't know if you can see that. Can you see that? Do you think I can fit my frame in this? We'll see. But it has the same cute little detail on the arm. And also, double. Thumb holes. Boop, boop. Last but not least, there is a jacket to keep me warm when I'm running, to keep me dry when I'm running and it's raining. It's cute and it feels really, really cool. Little fleece inside here. Feels good. I like. I'm gonna run with no trainers. I got the trainers right here. I went for a gait analysis at Nike Town in London, and what they have you do, if you don't know what it is, because I didn't know what it was, they have you run on a treadmill while they film you from the back. From the back, honey. Checking out your running style. So they put you in regular trainers, have you running, and what they're trying to see is how you, if you run on the flat of your foot, or if you supinate, or if you pronate. So if you run to the inside, I think that's called pronating. If you run to the outside, it's called supination, pronation, and running on the flat is running on the flat, honey. I run on the flat of my foot, but I also run on like the ball of my foot, like I run on my toes. So there's two type of trainers that I can wear to run in. The first one they showed me was the Nike Air Pegasus, and they showed me in a black and white, which I was like, they opened the box, I was like, oh, they are cute. And they were like, really? And I was like, yeah. And Vicky was like, is it because they're black and white? And I was like, girl, please. Yes it is. Don't try and know me. How dare you. This is them. They got the padding up here for my running style, you know, running on the flat and everything, you know what I mean? So that part of my foot is protected, so I'm not gonna get, you know, aches and pains because I'm running in the wrong type of trainer for my running style. I like. The second style was the Luna Glide 6.
Okay.
They've got the same kind of padded insole at the front, but the difference between these and these is that these have like a Cajun on the top built into the upper, so it holds you down. Holds you down, honey. I went on the treadmill, I think, like 4 times. The first time was to run in the generic trainers. The second time was to run in these. The third time was to run in these. Now, bearing in mind, I don't run. Every time I came off of the treadmill, they were like, so how did that feel? And I'm like, I don't know. I was concentrating on running. The last time I went on, I put one of this and one of this. And that's when I could feel the difference. So this one, I felt like it held my foot more. It was more like a whole experience for the whole foot, like it wrapped around everything. This part here was held down. So it feels more secure. Because this, compared to this, felt a little bit flimsy. It didn't feel flimsy by itself, but when I wore it with this, it felt flimsy. This trainer also has like a little something in the back here. So when you get fatigued, and you're no longer running on the front of your foot, and you might want to start walking, or you might want to start using the rest of your feet, it has a little something built in the back in order to support the rest of your foot. That is the kit, honey. The Nike Plus running app. What Vicky told me was that, look at that, ain't that cute? I need to get some socks as well, actually. I need to get some socks for running so I don't get no blisters and no corns on my feet, honey. Honey. What she told me was, you can go in here, you can put what kind of runner you are, beginner, advanced, intermediate, whatever, and you can say what kind of race you're training for. I went into coach, I've tapped in beginner, I've tapped in 10K, and I've pretended that the 10K starts on whatever date is 8 weeks from now. And the training starts tomorrow. Now the first thing that it wants me to do is a 4.83 kilometer run. Is that not half of the race that I'm doing in 3 months time? April, May, June. In 3 months time. Being that I'm a beginner, I'll do my 8 weeks now, and then after that I'll do another, I think it's another 7 weeks until the race, so I'll be doing another 7 weeks training. That's where I stand. So you might want to wish me luck with the training. The race is the 21st of June. I've roped my aunt into doing it with me because she told me how much she loves running. So I've asked her to do it and she is ecstatic. I'm gonna try and live off some of her energy. I think by the time I get to the race, I'll be all right. Like once I start training and like seeing what my stamina is and how I get on, I'm gonna be good, child. I'm gonna keep telling myself that. I'm gonna do my run tomorrow, 4.83 kilometers. Heart palpitations. Anyway, I'm a child. I hope I can do 12K, because when I can do 12K, I'm gonna blitz that 10K, honey. I'm gonna get from start to finish, honey. And I ain't gonna be the last one, honey. Don't even get me started. Don't. Okay. Thanks for watching.